Welcome to Amsterdam, the Dutch capital and one of the world's best gay travel destinations. Hey everyone, Two Gay Expats here. I'm Andy.
And I'm Trey. We're back in one of our favorite cities, excited to take you with us to explore the best of gay Amsterdam. Are you ready?
Let's go.
Amsterdam has a long history of LGBTQ plus acceptance and has been at the forefront of gay rights for decades. The Netherlands was also the first country to legalize same-sex marriage back in 2001, and the city is known for its inclusive and welcoming atmosphere.
From gorgeous canal-side hotels to legendary gay bars and clubs, it's no wonder many refer to Amsterdam as the gay capital of Europe. It's also called the Venice of the North, for its many hand-dug canals from the Dutch Golden Age in the 1700s, making Amsterdam one of the wealthiest cities in the world.
Don't miss the Homo Monument, an iconic landmark dedicated to the memory of gays and lesbians persecuted throughout history. It's a testament to the city's ongoing commitment to equality and diversity.
Beside the Homo Monument, make a stop at Pink Point, Amsterdam's official LGBTQ+ information kiosk, where you can speak with volunteers, shop Pride-related merch, and pick up free gay maps and club flyers.
Of course, the best way to explore Amsterdam is by bike or on foot, and there are bikes everywhere. Amsterdam is also a very safe and walkable city. Just watch out for the bikes.
Turning to nightlife, one thing you'll quickly notice is that the Dutch are not a prudish people when it comes to sex. You've probably heard of the famous red light district, which comes alive at dusk. Even within the gay community, you'll find both day and nightlife options that range from PG to your wildest imagination.
One of the best gay bars to kick off your visit to Amsterdam is the local and tourist favorite cheekily called Prik, P-R-I-K. This rather polished, upscale gay bar serves colorful cocktails in a very pink-themed establishment. We love the good vibes and positive energy every time we come to this trendy bar. The crowd is quite diverse, ranging from young lesbians to groups of friends of mixed ages and all races. One thing you'll quickly notice about Amsterdam is that everyone is welcome, and surprisingly, English is spoken everywhere.
Another popular and cozy gay bar to visit early on in your trip is Queen's Head. Drag Queen Bingo and Thursdays Are a Drag are both great nights. Arrive early for the best seats and enjoy the friendly service and well-priced beverages in this fun and quirky pub. We grab some beers at the bar and enjoy multiple rounds as we peruse the gay rags before the show. Similar to Prik, Queen's Head is the perfect first stop on the gay nightlife scene to get acclimated and pick up a free gay map that highlights all of the latest queer events in Amsterdam.
Taking things up a notch, a local friend of ours that used to work at Club Church tells us Blue on Thursdays is the gay club's best night of the week. It's Amsterdam's self-described most absurd dance party. All genders and sexualities are welcome at this party, with free entrance for those coming in drag or naked. We decide to save the 25 euro cover for two, check our clothes for free, and dance the night away in our birthday suits.
While cameras are normally forbidden here, an exception seems to be made for tonight's launch of Church's Queer Beer. For sure, you cannot film anything upstairs or downstairs, which has multiple adult play spaces. The music and energy at Club Church is simply amazing. It's our favorite gay club in Amsterdam by far. The bartenders are also super nice and quite flirty as well.
After dancing for hours, if you're looking for a relaxed nightcap, walk over to the new gay bar by Club Church called Free Willy. It's another nudist bar with pool table and curtain banquettes for canoodling. It's also open till 5 a.m., which means it's a late night place. As an FYI, Club Church are also the people behind the only gay sauna for men, called NZ for short. It's stylish, popular, and centrally located. Many people we met tonight tell us they absolutely love it and went before their night out.
Beyond the nightlife, which we'll explore more of shortly, Amsterdam is packed with cultural and historical attractions. But first, let's give you a quick tour of our sleek, sophisticated, and modern hotel. We're staying at the incredible Andaz, part of the Hyatt brand, which is located just steps from Club Church.
As far as amenities, we love the spa with shower for two and sauna on arrival to combat any jet lag. Andaz also offers free local gin tasting in the evening, available to enjoy either in the restaurant or garden. The garden is full of fun artwork and murals. Heading inside, rooms are quite spacious and unique, with complimentary mini bars too. We scored this room using 29,000 Hyatt Awards points per night because the rack rate was shockingly over 900 euros per night. Europe has indeed become very expensive for summer travel.
Now let's talk about must-see things to do in Amsterdam. For first-time visitors, we recommend the Anne Frank House, which is just behind the HOMO Monument, and the Rijksmuseum to see a vast European art collection, including plenty of Dutch masters. The gardens surrounding the museum and the nearby gay popular Vondelpark are also quite impressive.
Tasting some of the delicious food is another must-win in Amsterdam. A few of our favorites include the famous pistachio cruffin at Bakery St. John, pancakes at Pancake House upstairs, and brunch outside at the gay-friendly New Dutch Cafe. We're also obsessed with the fries at Fable Friet, around the corner from the Andaz.
In addition to sampling local specialties, a boat tour in the canals is a must. This is my third time organizing one, so we opt for a longer 2-hour experience on an electric boat to explore a little further afield. Our fantastic captain offers us a full bar of wine and cheese, as well as local beers. We even have real glassware, which we always appreciate as we gently cruise along the waterways.
A few highlights you can see on a canal tour include the dancing houses on the Amstel River, the view of 7 arched bridges in a row, and even a windmill where the beer we have on board is brewed. It's also incredibly relaxing, especially in the evening after a full day of exploring the city on foot.
Next, let's walk over to Reguliers, which is the oldest gay street in Amsterdam for over 40 years. Gay bars Blend, Taboo, Soho, Exit, Nix, and Blend XL, to name a few, are all located on this street, so it's easy to go bar hopping among them. We're slightly partial to Taboo and Soho, but all are fun and have different theme nights and drink specials, so definitely check out their social media for the latest events. Soho, for example, is known for Wild Wednesdays for 2 euro beers and dancing. Weekends are also super popular, as you can see here, for a Heineken street takeover.
As we walk over to our next gay bar, we want to give a quick shout out for Sunday Funday at De Troot. It's super popular with the younger queer community. It's run by volunteers to support LGBTQ projects worldwide, and phones must be switched off on entry.
Now, for one of the oldest gay bars in Amsterdam, Spiker Bar has been separating the men from the boys since 1978. It's pretty chill at happy hour, but definitely gets spicier as the night unfolds. There are lockers by the front door if you want a drink in the buff, and a small dark room upstairs. Spiker Bar is a great warm-up spot for Club Church, which is always a great place to end your night.
As far as our travel tips, we love that you can use your phone to pay everywhere, including bars and clubs. An Apple Watch comes in handy if you've checked your clothes. No tipping, no receipts to sign. You can also pay for all public transit, including trams and trains, by phone. You don't need a ticket, just be sure to tap your phone on the way out. We made the mistake of buying a train ticket from the airport to Amsterdam Central Station on arrival. It's not necessary.
For the best time to visit, for sure we recommend summer or shoulder seasons, as winters can be cold and wet. In June, there's the Queer Tropicale Festival and Amsterdam Pride in late July, early August.
In terms of logistics, most international visitors arrive by air at Schiphol International Airport, airport code AMS. It's easy to navigate as there are signs everywhere and directions are well marked. Uber is available, but the train to Central Station and onward trams or walking is likely your best bet.
For where to stay, gay-friendly options include the Andaz, which we've highlighted already, and the Dylan. This traditional canal-side hotel feels warm and cozy and hosts gorgeous gay weddings. We also love the Pulitzer, a 5-star classic with an incredible bar for cocktails. We'll add links for you to all of these amazing hotels in the description and comments. And for our favorite budget option that we scored for under 100 euros per night, we'll reveal that name over on our website at tugaexpats.com.
Well, that's a wrap for us in Gay Amsterdam. Where's your favorite city escape in Europe? We'd love to hear from you down in the comments.
We're also curious if you prefer our city guides like this one, gay hotel reviews, or nightlife videos. Be sure to let us know what you'd like to see more of.
And if you like today's video, do us a favor and smash that like button for the almighty YouTube algorithm and consider subscribing to our channel.
For more gay travel inspiration, we now have you covered from A to Z, Amsterdam to Cibalite, right here on YouTube and over on our travel blog at togetexpats.com. Be sure to check it out and follow us on Instagram at togetexpats.
We also want to thank our channel members. We greatly appreciate your support.
Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next adventure.
Tot ziens!